A good way to look at a solar eclipse is using a pair of binoculars or a telescope like this and projecting the image onto a piece of paper. You don't want to look into the binoculars or telescope directly, it will damage your eyes, so that's very important. Here you'll see two images, that's because these are binoculars, and the focus does matter on the binoculars. Here I'm focused into a power line running directly across the view of the sun here across the street. But I refocus and you can see the sun, and you can actually see sunspots on the sun. There's the power line out of focus, but those spots you see are sunspots on the sun right now. It might be kind of hard to tell on the camera, but the sun is looking kind of dim. You'll notice the moon appears as a dark shadow coming across the sun right now. If you don't have binoculars or a telescope, you can use two sheets of paper and poke a pinhole in one piece of paper and then hold the other paper about a foot or two away like this, and you'll see the same image, but it'll be much smaller. This will work though. You just need a little better eyesight. Here you'll notice a lot of spots appear to be on the sun, but this isn't sunspots. This is trees, leaves on a tree that are across from my property here that I'm focused in on now. I'm not focused on the sun. It's getting close to sunset anyhow, but the sun still does appear about half lit here. A little dim. It's getting kind of low for me now, but you can kind of see the image of the moon there crossing the sun yet, with the tree leaves. I'm not focused on the sun. Yeah, I did move out of the way a little bit and got some of those leaves out of the way temporarily. Now they're back. You can see the leaves. I'm focused on those and a telephone pole across the street here. And you can see the image of the moon here, and it looks like it's moving out of the way slightly from the sun now. I think that's going to be about it. Thanks for watching.